My name is Ben Nwankwo, a three-time member of the House of Representatives, representing Orumba North, Orumba South federal constituency, being presently threatened by erosion haram. First and foremost, these are the people of Orumba North, Orumba South federal constituency in Anambra State. We are here on a triple mission. The first is to commend the federal government of Nigeria through the vice president on their very gigantuan impetus towards the burial of Dr. Alex Ekwueme. The second mission was to notify them of the war going on in Orumba North and South between erosion and the people as to who owns the land. While there is Boko Haram in the north, east, there is erosion haram in the southeast, particularly in Anambra State. And Agolo, Oko, Nanka, down to Umunze is the deepest erosion gully in the country. And we have notified the vice president of this situation. About 100 houses have caved in, and many hundreds of people rendered homeless. They are squatting at some various places, and we are asking for international intervention, especially in the area of survey, risk assessment, mapping, and engineer and ecological engineering. But more importantly, or most importantly, we are asking that the site in total should be declared ecological emergency in order to give it the attention that it rightly deserves, so that the international community also should be able to come into it. Otherwise, in the next 2 years, there will be more disaster. So we want to err on the side of caution by informing the federal government of this condition of our people. The thought is that we came in to ask, Orumba is the remnant of nature's virginity in Anambra State, apart from the erosion incursion, that is naturally an academic environment, that the two federal institutions, Federal Polytechnic Oko in Orumba North and the Federal College of Education Technical Umunze in Orumba South, be granted degree awarding status, so that they don't get to producing numerous manpower that will not be utilized by the industry. If it is more trendy, it's more international, and I can cite about 13 countries that have polytechnic university, and without necessarily even calling it a polytechnic university, you can allow them to be awarding degrees in technically or technology-based courses. The same thing with the Federal College of Education Technical University. In summary, these are the things that brought us to Presidential Villa, and to wish the Vice President and by extension the President well in their onerous task of refixing Nigeria. This is why we are here, Mr. Chairman. Thank you very much.
Very much has been done since then. The situation is worse than it was when you last came, and will continue to grow worse with every rain until something is done. We are pleading and praying and urging the government to do everything possible to start work on it with international help. It's beyond the community, it's beyond the state, it's perhaps even beyond the federal government, but at least they can initiate the process of getting outside bodies to assist. So we are in great danger of losing the whole community and beyond. So whatever the media can help, however the media can help to urge everybody to come to assistance and save our souls, we will appreciate it.
What was the response of the Vice President?
Oh, he was very positive. We appreciate the Vice President's response enormously. He's a gentleman for excellence, and he was very receiving and concerned about our plight. And he says he'll do whatever is within his power and the government's power to assist. But he also has left us with some homework to do ourselves, to strengthen his hands. So we appreciate his sincerity.